Example, quoted annual rate is 6%, compounded monthly. What is the effective annual interest rate? If you use the formula, then the quoted rate would be 6% or 0.06 in decimals. M is 12, because monthly compounded means compounding means 12 times per year. And your answer will be 6.1678%. In the financial calculator, you do the following. Let's clear everything we had earlier. Second, plus, minus, enter. Let's not worry about changing the decimals, increasing the decimals. Let's leave it at 2. So you press second, 2. The nominal rate is 6%. You put 6, enter. Press the down arrow key or up arrow key, either one. Stop when you see compounding per year. You want to change it to 12 times a year, monthly compounding. 12, enter. Then either up or down arrow key, keep pressing stop when you see EFF, effective. Press compute. 6.17% per year, right? It's actually rounded to the second decimal place. The more accurate percentage would be like on my slide, 6.1678%. So it's a little bit below than what the calculator gave us. The important thing you should realize is that with compounding more than once a year, effectively you're earning more money. So let's say you are saving money in some bank account. Do you want compounding to be more frequent or less frequent? The answer should be more frequent, because you want to earn as high interest rate as possible. Now, let's think of a different example. You are taking a loan. You're borrowing money. Do you want the interest rate on your loan to be compounded more frequently in 1 year or less frequently? The answer this time should be less frequently, because you want to pay a lower interest rate on the money that you borrowed. So it kind of depends which side you're on, whether you're a saver or a borrower. When the question is, should compounding be more frequent or less frequent, right? What is APR, annual percentage rate? It's the same thing as quoted rate or stated rate or nominal rate, which is how the financial calculator calls it. This is what the term that banks use. If you go to Bank of America website or Wells Fargo website, they call their interest rates APR. And this is actually the rate that banks are required by law to report to their customers. So you will always see the APR on your checking account, savings account, credit card, and so on. To find the interest rate per each compounding time interval, which is the period rate, you take the APR per year and divide by the number of periods per year. You should never divide the effective rate by the number of periods per year. It will give you a slightly higher number than the correct interest earned over each compounding interval. Example, a bank charges 1.3% per month on car loans. What does it mean? What is this bank going to report to customers by law? It's going to report the annual interest rate, or the APR, annual percentage rate, of 15.6%, which is 12 times 1.3% per month. But if you take a loan to buy a car, if you leave a balance unpaid for one full year, are you going to be asked to pay another 15.6% on the amount that you owe? No. It's going to be more than that. It's calculated according to the effective annual rate, right? So how do we get 16.77% per year? We just use the EAR formula. By the way, banks call it APY, annual percentage yield. So APR is like the stated, quoted, nominal rate. APY is the effective rate. And of course, we can verify this result in the financial calculator. Let's clear everything first. Second, plus, minus, enter. Let's increase the decimal places this time. Second, decimal place, let's make it 6. Enter. And now let's convert the APR of 15.6% into the effective annual rate, which should be always a slightly higher number. Second, 2. What's the nominal rate? 15.6. I press 15.6, enter. Then down arrow key again. I stop when I see compounding per year. I change it to 12. 12, enter. Down arrow key again. One more time. I stop when I see effective and I press compute. 16.765178% per year. This is the effective rate. If you round it to two decimal places, you will get 16.77%, like on my slide. So this rate, the banks are not required to report this higher rate to their customers, even though this is technically the true interest rate that you owe on your balance after not paying it for one full year. You may or may not see it on your bank's page, but banks are only required by law to report the APR, sort of the underestimated one, the lower one of the two. Let's look at this example. You deposit $1,000 in a bank account with stated annual interest rate of 8% compounded quarterly. How much money will you have in your account in 5 years? So clearly there's compounding going on quarterly. So you probably will need to calculate the effective rate. But this is not what the question is asking. This actually is a two-step problem. In the second step, you're asked to calculate the future value after 5 years of $1,000 that you put in your bank account today. So how should we solve this problem? The first step, we calculate like by how many percent per year does your money really grow when we account for the quarterly compounding. And it's going to be a little bit more than 8%. So step one, we calculate the effective annual rate. We can use the formula, use 4 for M and 8% for the quoted rate. That gives us 8.2432%. And then we use it in the second step to find how much you have in your account after 5 years. So we are using the effective annual rate to calculate the future value. And the effective annual rate is gonna be our interest rate in the formula. So we have the future value in 5 years equals $1,000 multiplied by 1 plus 0.082434, and you close parentheses and raise the parentheses term to the power of 5. The answer you get is $1,485.90. This is one way to solve this problem, and you can do both steps in the financial calculator, right? There is a different solution, which is a lot easier. You can first realize that we have a total of 20 quarters over 5 next years. Then every quarter you earn a 2% interest rate on your money, which is 8% per year divided by 4 quarters. And then in the third step, you find the future value after 5 years using 20 quarters for your number of time periods and 2% quarterly rate for the correct interest rate, and you find the same result. So in the second solution, you skip calculating the effective annual rate completely. You don't even use it. Example, what is the maximum you should be willing to pay for an investment that pays $1,000 at the end of each year for 10 years, if the interest rate is 5% compounded daily. What is the main question that we are answering here? The maximum you should be willing to pay for an investment. So that's today's value of some future amounts of money you'll be getting back. You'll be getting back $1,000 every year for 10 years. So this is an annuity problem, and we need to find the annuity present value. Okay, what are we going to use for the annuity PMT? $1,000. What are we going to use for the annuity N? 10, because we have 10 equal payments made to us. What are we going to use for the annuity IY, interest rate? 5%? No. We need to account for the daily compounding. So it's actually going to be something a little bit higher than 5% effectively. How much? Step one, calculate effective annual rate using 365 for your compounding frequency. Of course, you can use the financial calculator where the nominal rate is 5, compounding per year is 365, and you're computing the effective rate. We get 5.1267% per year. It's a little bit higher than the quoted rate of 5%, which is how it should always be. And then in the second step, you use the effective rate as the interest rate to find the annuity present value. So your annuity payment is 1,000. Your annuity interest rate, IY, is 5.1267, which is the effective rate. And the annuity number of payments is 10, as given. Compute present value. The answer is $7,674. Let's do this in the financial calculator. Let's start by clearing everything. Second, plus, minus, enter. Let's increase the decimal places. Second decimal place, let's make it 6. 6, enter. Step 1, calculate the effective rate. You press second, 2. The nominal rate, which needs to be entered first, is 5% quoted rate, which is given. You put 5, enter. Press either up or down arrow key and stop. Keep pressing and stop until you when you see compounding per year, C over Y. Change it to what? Change it to daily compounding. How many times a year is that? 365. So press 365, enter. Well, technically there are leap years every 4 years with 366, but in finance, we just kind of agree to always use 365. Okay, so we enter 365, we pressed enter, now it's saved. Now you press up or down arrow key and stop when you see effective on the display. Press compute. 5.1267, and we actually have a couple more, 50, which we don't have on the slide. So this is the effective rate. Okay, now let's clear everything again. Let's increase the decimals. Second format or decimal place. Let's make it 6 again. 6, enter. Let's start. We need to calculate annuity present value. So we will be computing present value. For that, we need to enter N, IY, and PMT. What is our N? We have a total of 10 future payments that will be made to us on the investment we are buying now. So put 10 N. How much are we going to be paid every year? $1,000. Put 1,000, change the sign to negative, and save it as PMT. And last but not least, what's the interest rate? That's the effective annual rate from the first step of our calculations. Put 5 point, remember we don't use decimals, So you need to kind of move the decimal place by 2 to the right. 5.1267. 5.1267. And I think we also had two more numbers when we did it in the calculator, which were 50. So let's do that. That's our interest per year. Compute PV. $7,674, like on the slide. And we also have some cents, approximately 43 cents, rounded to the second decimal place. So this is a two-step problem in which the effective annual rate is the first step you do. And that's part of a much bigger problem, something like find annuity present value. Or a different problem would ask you to find annuity future value. Or maybe find the present value of multiple cash flows, or future value of multiple cash flows, or something with perpetuities. In the previous problem, what if $1,000 that will be paid to you every year on the investment you will be buying now will never end? That's a perpetuity. Same first step, find the effective annual rate with daily compounding. We already know that it's 5.1267% per year. And in the second step, you use this as the discount rate to find the perpetuity present value. The perpetuity present value formula says take the perpetuity payment and divide it by the interest rate or discount rate. The perpetuity payment is $1,000. The correct discount rate is the effective rate from the first step, 5.1267%. The answer we get is $19,506. It's probably rounded a little bit.